Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the York Hall, Bethnal Green, the home of British boxing, for tonight's main event. Frank Warren, in association with frankwarren.tv, proudly present 12 three-minute rounds for the Lightweight Championship of Europe, live and exclusive on Sky Sports HD Saturday Fight Night. Your officials are appointed by the European Boxing Union and the British Boxing Board of Control, and your three scoring judges at ringside are Mr. Rajko Jagic of Serbia, from Italy, Mr. Pierluigi Poppi, and from France, Mr. Jean-Francois Toupin. Your British Boxing Board of Control steward in charge is Mr. Phil Lundgren, and your EBU supervisor is Mr. Jean-Marcel Nartz of Germany. When the action begins, your referee in charge is Guido Cavalieri of Italy. Your timekeeper, the bell, is Bob Edgeworth. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, the challenger, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white shorts at yesterday's weigh-in. He scaled 9 stone, 8 pounds, 4 ounces. He comes to the ring tonight with 11 wins, 1 loss, 2 draws, with 4 of those wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, from Barcelona in Spain, please welcome to London the challenger for the title, Karim El Ouazghari. And across the ring is the reigning and defending European champion and former undefeated English champion and former undefeated British champion, wearing the black and gold shorts. He weighed in 9 stone, 8 pounds, 12 ounces. And tonight is making the second defense of his European title and aiming to extend the current longest unbeaten run in British boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, he comes with a record of 30 wins from 30 contests, with 18 of those wins coming by knockout. Please welcome, from Manchester, the WBC number 2 ranked lightweight and reigning and defending European lightweight champion, John Murray. Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Gentlemen, remember what I told you in the changing room, okay?
But Manchester's exciting. John Murray hits the capital. Sorry, Colin.
No, I was just going to say, at least the referee speaks better English than Fabio Capello.
He certainly does. John Murray in the second defence of his European lightweight title, taking on Spanish challenger Karim El Ouazghari. Murray with it all to lose. He's the WBC number 2. He's eyeing up world title fights. He's eyeing up a big domestic showdown with Kevin Mitchell. How will he look here at the historic York Hall in Bethnal Green, where so many great fighters have fought over the years? I remember Ricky Hatton coming down here, coming of age fight for him. I think it was Giuseppe Lowry he fought down here, and he brought his army of fans down, and Murray's done the same.
They're certainly noisy. The Spaniard is a bit of an unknown quantity. He's never fought outside of Spain. He's only had 14 fights. We don't know how good he is, and neither does John Murray, because he hasn't seen any video of him. He said he's boxing like they used to do in the old days, boxing blind, working it out as he goes along.
Ouazghari doesn't look a threat, particularly on paper. 31 years of age. Couple of draws and a defeat in those 14 fights. His head looks a little bit rigid and upright, doesn't it, on those shoulders? It doesn't seem an awful lot of bend there.
And he's catching Murray with some good left hooks.
He's caught Murray once or twice. Murray can sometimes take a while to warm up. And hasn't always had the best defence in the world. Although he tends to grind people down, heads clash a little bit there. Murray, an aggressive, crowd-pleasing, pressure fighter, comes forward, high guard, works the body. You can see why the fans like him. Always looks so intense and so intent in there.
The Spaniard has not got off to a bad start.
Heads rubbing together, the Spaniard complains. But as you say, Colin, John Murray has got caught once or twice. Perhaps a little bit tense and eager to please here in London. Especially his new promoter, Frank Warren, who sat ringside. A little bit off target so far, Murray. Hasn't quite found his rhythm or his timing. Decent body shot there from him. With the right hand round the side.
Well, he's no monk, the Spaniard. Just the opening couple of minutes or anything to go by.
Rather ungainly and unorthodox, a bit awkward to box. And Murray struggled to work him out. A little bit of a flapping punch that from Ouzghari. With the right hand. Interesting opening round.
Well, I made it. The Spaniard win that. You know, Murray regards this really as the start of his career, although he's had 30 fights and 30 wins and the longest unbeaten record in British boxing. He believes his career is really going to take off from now. And he's hoping that his new promoter, Frank Warren, will get him a world title fight by the end of the year. He's ranked number two by the WBC. And he's in the top 10 of most organizations' lists. So he's knocking on the door. And of course, the world champions are all Mexican.
The question is, will he continue to improve? He's 26 years of age, but as you say, 30 straight wins, and some of those were quite tough battles. Is he still improving? Has he plateaued?
Well, of course, he's been out the ring for 7 months, so there's a certain amount of rustiness there. And I think it showed in that opening round. But as you more or less hinted, Ed, he may be trying too hard to please. Well, that's probably... Only 3 minutes has gone, so we've got to be a bit more patient to see how this pans out.
Murray, very much a front foot boxer. Normally throws nice, short, sharp combinations with a tight defense, but timing still a little bit off. Caught there from a wild swing from Ouzghari, who's unorthodox. But effective so far. And Murray does mark up sometimes, even in winning fights. There's a worry, heads banging together and him getting clumped with some of these awkward shots. It would be a massive upset if he lost.
Oh, don't even bear thinking about. I thought Ouzghari there with a very good short right on the chin. And Ouzghari, he senses that Ouzghari was hurt with that punch. And he's storming after him.
Murray does look very tense, like he's really forcing the punches out, looking to hurt Ouzghari. Maybe he'd be better served just relaxing a little bit, establishing the jab. Even that jab that he's just thrown, he's putting everything into it. He's just trying so hard to hurt Ouzghari, isn't he? As opposed to outbox him or outthink him or outwork him or anything sensible early.
He's having a much better round this round, Ed.
The body shots are starting to tell.
He's jolting Uzgari's head back as well.
Yeah, better stuff from Murray. Switches to southpaw a little bit. Digs the body shots in. Getting his head jolted back a little bit every now and again, and by a left hook there. This guy's come to win, and he's caught Murray a couple of times there. Murray standing completely square on, trading, getting hit unnecessarily. Pleasing the fans. I don't know whether his cornerman, Joe Gallagher, will be that impressed. Probably mixed feelings for promoter Frank Warren. This is what the crowd love to see, and the people watching it at home, but he would need to look better than this if he's to step up another level, which is the plan. Another exciting round.
Oh, Murray definitely took that round. Put a lot of pressure on Uzgawi and hurt him quite a few times, particularly a couple of punches to the head. Had Uzgawi's spray coming off his forehead as the punches landed.
Not a vintage performance so far, though, from Murray. His timing has looked off, perhaps because of the inactivity. The punches look a little bit forced. He doesn't look like he's concerned with his defence too much. Maybe he is underestimated Uzgawi. Maybe he feels he can just walk through him. Maybe he wants to make a statement about how exciting he is. I wonder what Kevin Mitchell will be thinking sat ringside. There's definitely flaws there in the Murray makeup on this performance tonight.
Yeah, he's not difficult to hit, is he?
No. Murray tends to block punches as opposed to slip them or use his footwork. He's got that high guard. He catches a lot of them on the gloves. Slightly higher, tighter guard in this round for Murray. He still gets clipped with the left hook. Maybe he could do with a few rounds to shed some of this rust, if that's what it is. That's better for Murray, I think. A little bit shorter in the shots. To the body as well from Murray, who seems to be finding some kind of rhythm here in the third. Uzgawi still having his moments. A good right hand there from Murray, brought it around the side, digging the left hooks to the body.
Yeah, he's intent on wearing Uzgawi down. He keeping up a non-stop aggression. Yeah, Uzgawi backing against the rope. He's really punching hard to the body, Murray.
What a fight him and Mitchell would be. Two sets of partisan fans. Be a hard fight to pick.
You could sell a few tickets for that one.
Yeah. Mitchell at one stage had the longest unbeaten run in British boxing. Now it's Murray. Mitchell with just the only defeat in world class to Michael Katsidis at Upton Park.
Believe it or not, that was 11 months ago.
Time flies. Good sustained attack here from Murray, cranking up the pressure. Uzgawi looks towards his corner. He's just starting to be a little bit overwhelmed by the pressure of Murray.
He does like a tear up, doesn't he?
He really does.
As you said, Ed, this is the sort of fight the fans love to watch.
We've seen a few of them at York Hall, haven't we, Colin?
Yeah, it brings out the beast in them, there's no doubt about that. Well, as you said, Murray's now beginning to get into a kind of rhythm and he's punching away with both hands and attacking non-stop, forcing Uzgawi on the back foot all the time. And he's beginning, I think, to take control of the fight.
Uzgawi, known as El Diablo, the devil.
He's also a great Barcelona soccer fan, that's for sure. So he was telling us at the press conference he wears the Barcelona badge on his tracksuit. Murray, of course, is a Man City fan.
Fourth round here. It's been a good little scrap so far. Some people doubted the credentials of Kareem El Ouzghari going in. A little bit inexperienced. Already travelled. Nothing on his record to suggest he'd give John Murray, who's pushing towards world class, a tough test. But so far it has been competitive. It has been exciting. Murray has been hit.
But thankfully, he's managed to hit Ouzghari more times than Ouzghari has hit him.
I mean, Colin, do you think Murray will have to improve his defence if he's going to step up to world class, especially against those tough Mexicans?
Marquez and people like him.
Humberto Soto.
Marquez, Soto, Vasquez, Guerrero. They're in a different league than most of our fighters, so you know he would have to tighten his defence a little, I think, if he fought those guys. Certainly Marquez.
Good body shots again there from Murray on the march forward, where he's most comfortable. And it must be said, I've seen better from Murray in the past. Had some success with the left hook to the body there. El Ouzghari dropped his guard a little bit. Obviously felt it. But a little bit over-exuberant, a bit ragged maybe from John Murray. Maybe over-eager to please.
And the Spaniard takes a good shot.
He does that. Great and toe-to-toe exchanges here.
I mean, Murray hit him with a peach of a right. Flush on the chin. Didn't faze him.
Oh,
and another one.
It does make you worry a little bit if that was Kevin Mitchell he was in against. Kevin Mitchell, a very respectable puncher himself. Turns Murray a bit on the ropes, catches him, cannot miss him with that straight right hand in it. Murray is marking up a little bit around the eyes, both eyes.
Well, that was a very close round, and I'm not so sure that Murray won it. I never give even rounds. But I think he just about scraped it, I would have thought, but it was very, very close because Ouzghari is fighting back very strongly. When he gets hurt particularly, he comes straight back at Murray. And Murray, as we've been saying, is not difficult to hit. And as you've already pointed out, he's beginning to mark up himself around the eyes. In fact, they're working on a swelling under his left eye as we speak.
That's it. Mick the Rub Williamson, London cabbie, famously worked with Lennox Lewis in one of his World Heavyweight title fights. But
and Ricky Hatton.
Ricky Hatton, yeah. Saved Ricky a few times, didn't he, with cuts?
Certainly did against Phillips, Vince Phillips that night.
And John Thaxton. Who, of course, Murray beat. As well about whether Murray is a little bit tight at lightweight. He lost his titles once before, the British title on the scales, before he fought Scott Lawton. And with the inactivity, it's even harder, isn't it?
Yep.
Getting the weight off. getting caught too much. Just a world-class fighter shouldn't get hit like that. Great offensively, but poor defensively is the judgment so far.
Well, the Spaniard has turned out to be quite a handful.
But is it the Spaniard being better than we thought, or is Murray not as good tonight as he has been in previous performances?
I think you're detracting from the Spaniard. I think he's better than we thought he would be.
Maybe I'm being a bit harsh on John, but that's the standards he set for himself as a potential world champion.
He's certainly a fit lad who's going.
Yeah, he looks in great shape. Maybe those left hooks to the body for Murray will start to tell. Overhand right from Murray.
But you see, his guy always takes those shots without batting an eyelid. He's got a very good chin.
Well, I know I've said it before, but Murray just looks so tense in there, doesn't he? He looks. Just needs to shake off some of those. That anxiety. Tends to be the aggressor. Good work from both of them. And Murray seems to be really teeing off here. Murray turns southpaw. I hope that doesn't mean there's a problem with his hand. He has done that.
I wonder how his guard is going to be a couple of rounds from now. Those body shots have been slamming into his ribs.
That's why Joe Gallagher took a long look at the corner of Kareem El Ouzghari when he climbed into the ring. It's not just John Murray with the impressive unbeaten record. Joe Gallagher has won his last 44 fights in the corner, 14 in title fights. Some record. Nothing wrong with those shots from Murray.
Long right cross. So he does takes a good shot, his goal, there's no doubt about that.
Corners, 10 seconds.
A lot of people, including me, didn't think it would go much past six rounds, this fight. On paper, that there's no sign that Ouzghari is going to be taken out in this round. Unless something sensational happens, because he seems to be able to take all that Murray throws at him.
Murray, an integral part of that Joe Gallagher gym that's had so much success recently. Anthony Crolla, the new British lightweight champion, stepped up from super featherweight to beat John Watson in an exciting fight. He's helping out in the corner. Murray's got more of a roll to his work this round, coming forward. Maybe starting to relax into it a bit. Even a feint there from him. There's not been an awful lot of thought about his work to start with. He's fighting like an aggressive machine.
Yeah, there's not much finesse, is there?
No. Murray turns southpaw, heaps the pressure on. Dean Powell, the matchmaker for Frank Warren, has just come over and agrees with us. He's winning it, John Murray, but making it a bit harder for himself than he needs to. Maybe it's the inactivity.
A combination of inactivity and trying very hard to please.
Great body punches there, though, from Murray.
Yeah, but Lusgari comes straight back at him, banging away with his body shots.
I've got to say, I'm not sure about the body language from Murray a little bit. His punches just seem to lack a little bit of snap. I'm not sure how steady his legs look. I know he's winning this round. When the referee pushes him back, he looks sluggish. And the hands are dropping a bit of Murray. Is this a worry? You don't often see John Murray with a low guard like that. Or open mouth. I'll give that round to Murray, but he's struggling.
No, he's finding it hard. He's not struggling to win the fight, I don't think. He's winning the fight all right. But each round is a hard round.
The thing is, though, Colin, we're expecting John Murray to go on and become a potential world champion, or certainly to challenge for a version of the world title. So on paper, he should have dealt with this guy a little bit more easily than he has done.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, this guy's not ranked high up in the ratings at all. But, as I say, don't want to make excuses for Murray, but we must make allowances for the fact that he has been out for 7 months. And this fight will do him the world of good, as long as he wins it.
Lusgari's only career loss, he was stopped in 4 rounds by Daniel Rosilla. He's not really a championship class fighter. Good attack from Murray. But El Lusgari will not fold.
And he's also, Lusgari's complaining about Murray's head. Not without some justification.
Yeah, Murray tends to plough forward, heads do bang together. He's a no-nonsense, all-action fighter. Perhaps you'd hope that Murray would have a plan B if, you know, the coming forward, aggressive style isn't working in a fight. I mean, obviously it's working, but if you're taking too many shots on the way in.
But Uzgari's nailing Murray in this round with some good hooks to the head and body. He's a tough nut.
Just a slip there.
Slip, he's gone down.
Referee acknowledges that it was just a slip. A wry smile from the Spaniard. It's all toe-to-toe, close-quarters stuff. They're not exactly using the ring, either of them.
They're not going by the textbook, are they?
No. He sets such a great pace, though, Murray, doesn't he?
And the referee does warn now Murray now for using his head when they get close.
He just plows forward, Murray. Seek and destroy. His expression rarely changes. Chin down, come forward.
But he's wild at the moment. I mean, the aggression is there, but the accuracy isn't. Well, I thought Uzgawi had a very good round then. A lot of the work he's doing is going unnoticed, I'm sure, by the fans, who only can only see one man. But he's banging away at Murray's when they get. When Murray gets close to him, he's banging away at his body, and and as I say, he's taking everything that's thrown at him. See if we can hear what the corner's saying.
Murray has stopped his last six opponents. He's not looking enormously likely that he'll continue that run this evening. Good lightweight battle. Murray jogs into action. Always eager for battle. And straight away has his opponent trapped against the ropes. He shoots such solid blows on the way in. Uzgari having some success with body shots as well. Grueling battle this one.
A much tougher fight, I think, than most people thought it would be. For Murray, that is.
Well, if we're honest, a better fight than most people thought it would be. Many dull ones, Murray. When you look through his recent record, stopping Lee Meagher, Lee McAllister, John Thaxton, Gary Buckland, Scott Lawton, Andrei Kudryavtsev, they were all very impressive performances. He's made rather harder work of this one, exciting as it has been.
Well, I think Uzgari's outboxing him at the moment in this round. Catching him all the time as he comes onto him.
Well, not the showcase performance we'd hoped for Murray. He's worn about the head again.
The next time he'll have a point taken of him.
Yeah, and he's the one who's marking up. He doesn't need heads banging together. The last thing he needs is to get cut here. Shots, good attack from Murray. And Uzgari smiles back at him as if to say he's not trouble. That normally means he is trouble. Both seem to have lost their balance a bit. But those body shots of Murray starting to pay dividends. Great action here.
He's like a buzzsaw, isn't he, Murray? He never stops flying leather.
He slumps back on the corner, though, at the end of the round.
Well, he's put a tremendous amount of effort into this fight.
Kevin Mitchell makes it all.
Well, from what he's seen, I bet he fancies it. Fancies Murray, I mean.
Mitchell was, of course, the original opponent listed for Murray this evening for one reason or another. Boxing politics stopped it happening.
I don't think it was politics, Ed. I think Mitchell didn't like the purse he was offered. He felt he was worth a lot more money than Frank Warren offered him. Even though he'd lost his last fight, in fact, he was stopped by Katsidis, and he was the challenger and not the champion. But Mitchell's argument was that he was going to sell the most of the tickets. But I'm sure that as long as Murray comes through this, they will fight.
It's too good a fight not to happen, isn't it?
Well, we've said that a few times, hasn't it? Mm-hmm. You know, just the greatest fight in the world is not happening at the moment, and that is Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather Jr.
Sure.
Which would be the richest fight in the history of boxing.
We live in hope.
Including all the heavyweights.
Still coming forward, Murray, still having his successes, but still getting caught himself. Heads bang together a bit. They'll both be sore tomorrow. And again, Murray a little bit dangerous with the head there, perhaps. We'll have to watch that. The referee's already picked him up on it twice. The rounds have flown by for us watching. I'm sure it's different in there. Tough battle if ever I saw one. How are you scoring it, Colin?
Oh, I've got Murray well ahead. But each round, although he's won the rounds, have been hard fought, and he's only just won them. Some of them, anyway. Been very close.
There's always the chance either one might suddenly fade, might hit the wall. It's been such a hard physical battle. Grueling, tiring.
I don't know whether Murray would want to fight Mitchell too quickly after this one.
No.
I mean, we were thinking maybe if we got this over quickly, it might happen on May the 21st, but I think that that's probably a bit doubtful now. This has been a real grueling battle.
Murray looks like he's bleeding from the mouth as well.
I think it's noticeable in this round that Musgari is not throwing many shots. I think he must now be really feeling the pace.
Mitchell himself just pushing his shots out a little bit now. Some of the snaps gone out of his work. Fans in good spirit. Murray's landed a lot of shots, a lot of body shots, a lot of head shots. Musgari has turned out to be a lot more durable than we expected. Timeout from the referee. Bringing them together, is he? Let's have a quick word. Not sure what he was complaining about there.
Probably warning them about their heads, I would have thought. There's been nothing else to warn them about, has there?
No. Very little holding. Sometimes a bit agricultural, the style of both, but earnest, exciting stuff. Both giving absolutely everything they've got. Good spell here from Eluzgari at the start of the 10th. Murray seemed to switch off a little bit there.
May have taken a breather in the previous round. He's certainly pushed, coming back very strongly in this round.
He's being pushed back here, Murray. And I worry in fights like this when you see someone hit so often, as Murray has been, whether it could catch up with him.
Oh well, Uzgari's certainly in control of this round so far.
I mean, Murray would really have to fade, you'd think, to give Uzgari a chance of the upset. You can't really see it on point, but sometimes different people have different interpretations of a fight. It's been a lot of the rounds have been quite close, I would say. I've kind of had Murray winning them. But it is a subjective art, scoring a fight.
Uzgari's complaining to the referee about something.
Couple of low blows.
Low
there.
Blows.
So that's three times he's been warned for various infringements. Murray.
Uzgari's corner are complaining bitterly to the referees about Murray's head and headwork and low punching. He's on the floor again, but again he was pushed down by Murray.
They're both obviously a little bit tired. Good attack from Murray. And Uzgari suddenly seems a bit disorganised and then flails back. Maybe it's just a balance thing with him as opposed to being hurt. And he's still teeing shots off back at Murray. They're increasingly a bit wild.
Well, I made Uzgari win that round, that's for sure. Although I've still got Murray comfortably ahead from his work early on.
When Ricky Hatton was coming through, people said maybe he got hit too much and that he wouldn't be able to step up and beat someone like Kostya Su. He was an underdog in that fight against a big puncher. And he found another level. Maybe John Murray has got that other level within him and needs a challenge. Maybe he's taken this guy lightly. It's inevitable if you keep winning at a certain level, you're going to start taking things for granted.
Well, I think Uzgari has shown us that John Murray has quite a few flaws. And if he wants to fight for world titles against the top Mexicans, he's going to have to do something about his defense. But yeah, 26, it's probably too late to do very much about it.
Maybe it's a mindset. Maybe sometimes you get in there and you think, I'm going to walk through this person. You switch your brain off a little bit mentally. There's blood on the face of Murray. I don't know whether that's from the nose or whether there's a slight cut or something. Looks okay.
Uzgari's corner, I'm urging him to go forward.
He looks a slightly more sprightly in this round again.
He's catching Murray so easily with both hands.
It'll be interesting to hear what Murray thinks of his own performance, how he assesses it.
Maybe it's fortunate that Uzgari's not a banger either.
is a tired look to Murray now.
Well, he has put a tremendous amount of effort into this fight, I must say.
It's 1.5 rounds to go.
Luzgari's winning this round for me as well.
It's worrying that, to be honest, the way he's getting hit here, Murray. He's every right to be tired, but he looks slightly like he's...
He is very, very weary now.
Time out from the referee, warned.
Oh! That is ridiculous. That is ridiculous. The referee has taken a point off Luzgari, presumably for the illegal use of the head, and yet he's been warning Murray all night for it. Well, there you go.
Murray was looking up at the big screen in the hall then to see the time left in the round. I think he'll be glad when the final bell goes, assuming it goes the distance. Maybe some lessons learned, can go back, study the tape, go back to the gym. Just could really do with this night's work being over now. He need to find another gear from somewhere. And bundles Luzgari over to the canvas, just a slip. And Luzgari starts complaining. And the referee's counting it as a knockdown.
I don't know where this Italian referee's getting it from. That is crazy. Absolutely crazy. So that means Luzgari has lost 2 points in this round.
So probably a 10-7.
10-8.
Even with a knockdown and the point off.
Knockdown. Oh, I see what you mean. Knockdown. Yes, it'll be 10-7. You're quite right. Knockdown. So he's lost 3 points. So he's obviously lost the fight.
You'd expect that to possibly damage his morale, but only one round to go.
Well, that makes him 7 points ahead as far as I'm concerned. Not that what my scorecard says matters, but to lose 3 points in that round is just ridiculous.
So it looks like he did virtually headbutt John Murray there. So fair enough from the referee to take that point off. No excuse for deliberate fouls like that, but the knockdown to us did not look legitimate.
Well, I don't know, facially, Murray looks more like a loser than a winner. He's marked up down both eyes.
Both energised, knowing there's only 3 minutes left. Colleagues at ringside here.
We like
have Murray 6 rounds up. That pretty much tallies with your scorecard, Colin. But perhaps the moral victor is El Luzgari, who's still in there battling away when people wrote him off. Wasn't expected to last 12 rounds. And he's taken his lumps. No real finesse with John Murray this evening with his work. Very few feints. Good attack this though. And he closed the show in the 12th round, John Murray. They both must be utterly exhausted. It's hot in here as well, isn't it?
Yes, and under the ring lights, it'll be even hotter.
York Hall here on Old Ford Road in Bethnal Green in the east end of London. They're both holding really for the first time, looking up at the clock, find out how long to go. Can't really blame them for that at this stage. Just over a minute left. Seems to have completely lost the energy to move. His legs are leaden. balance isn't really there anymore. But Murray too tired himself to really.
I think he's hit that. I think his guy has hit that wall we were talking about. At least Murray has the satisfaction of winning the 12th and last round.
Uzgari utterly exhausted.
Well, that knockdown was no different to the one he counted.
No. Last 10. This one's going the distance. Murray hits Uzgari around the back of the head. His frustration there. The referee's not happy. And he's taking a point off Murray.
But that makes it an even round.
A fair decision that they embrace at the final bell.
For what it's worth, my scorecard says 116-109.
Good scrap that one, but not really John Murray's coming out party in London.
Well, I don't know what promoter Frank Warren thinks of his performance, but I mean, what he'll say publicly and what he'll say privately may be two different things, but I don't think he could be overjoyed at what he saw tonight from Murray.
Still a great fight, him and Kevin Mitchell.
Oh.
Even harder to pick a winner. I think some people beforehand were saying that Kevin Mitchell's inactivity and losing to Michael Katsidis.
Well, of course, Kevin has been out for, if they fight, say, in June, he would have been out 13 months.
Mitchell wasn't boxing in a little 6 or 8 rounder on this bill just to get his sharpness back, to get all the fans to see them together.
Well, he won it comfortably, I think, but I don't think he was, I could say he was impressive, John Murray.
You can't sparkle every time. Maybe he underestimated his opponent.
I suppose what counts is winning.
Yeah. He moves to 31 straight wins. It's a very impressive record.
Well, despite all the head clashes and low blows and all the rest of it, the two fighters, as always in boxing, embrace each other, congratulate each other, and Murray very sportingly raises the Spaniard's hand so that he gets a round of applause.
Was there anything malicious there with Murray hitting El Uzgari around the back of the head? Do you think that was just...
No, I don't think so.
If you were looking at them both in the ring now and didn't know the result, you'd think El Uzgari had won.
And we have a unanimous decision. Yep. Judge Puppy, 116, 110. Russian judges, 117, 111. Judge Tupac, 115, 112. The winner in the blue corner and still. The European Heavyweight Champion from Manchester.
Going.
So Murray wins it by 6 rounds, 6 rounds and 3 rounds. Unanimous decision.